Christian Center and all those that may be tuning in or stumbling across us this morning. This is Wednesday, and it is not this beautiful a day as it was yesterday, but it's still the day the Lord has made. And so I choose to rejoice and be glad in it. Aren't you glad? We're not controlled by the weather. We're not controlled by circumstances to dictate to us how we feel and what we can do. Because the Bible says, greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. I'm not controlled by what things look like and feel like. I'm controlled and led by God's word and by the Spirit of God inside of me. The Bible says, Paul says to the very weak carnal church that was in Corinth, he says, you're acting like mere men, which the implication is we're not just human beings. We are men and women. We are human, but we're also, God lives on the inside of us through the Holy Spirit. And the Bible says in Romans 8, verse 11, if the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you, then he will quicken your mortal body. Well, if you're a Christian, the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you. So we're not just humans dealing with human condition, but we are the body of Christ here on the earth today. And I believe with all my heart for such a time as this. What I just want to share with you today is something God's been challenging me with. And that's, we talked the last 2 days about the importance and the power of our word, but it's also the importance and power of God's word to us. And one of the things God just impressed upon me really over a period of time is how easily I trust in the words of men, especially men that I may respect. I may not even know them, but because of their credentials or their experience, I have great confidence in them. And how often I have more confidence in what they say than in what God says. And I'll give you an example of this. Suppose, and this is what God showed me, suppose the headlines today were that a cure has been discovered for COVID-19 virus, a cure that's immediately effective that will be available to everyone in the world within the next 2 or 3 weeks. And I guarantee you that almost everybody that's afraid now would relax. And we feel confident because somebody in the media has told us that somebody has made this decision or this evaluation. And it may be entirely true. So we would relax based on the words of people that we don't even know. And there's been times that because I've gone to the doctor and I've been concerned about something in my body, and the doctor will say, oh, I'm not worried about that. And the moment he says that, I stop worrying. Why? Because I have great confidence in his words and his judgments. Now let's bring that over and compare that to, do we have that same confidence and assurance in God's word? When the word of God says that by his stripes I have been healed. When Psalm 91 says, that if I dwell in the secret place of the Most High, no plague can come near my dwelling. 1,000 may fall on one side and 10,000 on the other, but it's not going to come near me. Do I have the same confidence in that word that I have in the words of my doctor, that I have in the words of the experts that are out there? Do I? Because I just suggest to you, more than suggest, I encourage you to recognize that God's word deserves a greater place in our hearts, greater pace in our confidence than the words of any man, no matter how sincere, no matter how educated, no matter how right they are. And most of these doctors, most of these scientists are honest, will be honest enough to tell you that's the truth. But it's looking at ourselves now. Where is my trust and where is my confidence? God deserves to have the highest confidence in our lives. God deserves for us to trust, and his word is trustworthy. The problem is we don't trust in his word more than we trust in the words of others, especially the experts. So I just want to challenge you with that. That's what God's been challenging me with. Just let the Holy Spirit examine you today and show you, where is my trust really? And you can say that by what shakes me and what gives me peace. Is it reports I see in the world? As we see the death count rise from this, does that scare me? Then my trust really isn't in what God's assurance to me is. And I can't judge what the word will do for somebody else by their experience. I can only judge it by what God's word says to me. So I just want to encourage you with that, challenge you with a little bit today. God bless you. We love you and appreciate you. And we look forward to visiting again tomorrow. We'll see you then.